Hello and greetings from Iceland. It's time to go with the lava flow and see where it leads us. And I will also be checking out the earthquake map and the bigger picture, of course. But the lava flow is now on average almost 13 cubic meters per second, and it has advanced by an average of 300 to 400 meters per day, but varies from day to day, of course. Like when the crater rim collapsed, and there were some volcano tourists that got lucky when this occurred. If they weren't warned, they could have been a permanent part of our landscape, but luckily someone asked them to move only minutes before the crater rim collapsed, telling us again why people should not go so close, and do like me, get a good zoom lens or a drone. And a new lava flow model assumes that the lava will flow down to the sea by mid-August, and this is how it looks from the topography map, but this photo is also quite good for this. The crater is around here. We can also see the old fissures from 2021 and 22, and the new lava is already overlapping those relatively new lava fields. We might run into some troubles with the hiking trail up there, but I'm sure that it will be fixed. It's not that hard to move the road in this landscape. And when the lava reaches the South Coast Highway, we have actually entered a new chapter. But to see lava flow over roads, it has not happened since 1973, when a third of an entire town disappeared under lava in Westman Islands. And how serious is it if and when this road will close? When we look at the overall picture and the trouble that will for sure come with this chapter of seismic and volcanic unrest on a complete Reykjanes Peninsula for the next 200-300 years, there is absolutely no need to dramatize this too much. This highway, as we know it today, is only 10 years old. It replaced an older road that was always awful. And I say for myself that this was possibly one of the most forward-thinking road projects in Iceland in recent years. I was very glad when I got this new road, and I said back then that it will someday become an important part of evacuation plans, since I had been reading about the Reykjanes Peninsula, getting ready. But somehow I never believed that my generation would see such an event just by the back door to Reykjavik. And since the road opened, the importance has increased continuously. This is the alternative road to the international airport in Keflavík, and today it's a road we use to go to the volcano car parks. The only thing that will change is that if we go to the car park from Reykjavík, we will have to drive through Grindavík. So this isn't a big deal, and if and when the road gets flooded with lava, it might just be a very short part of it, maybe as little as 100 meters, even shorter. If the road administration decides to make a channel through the road before it's hit with lava, so that gap could be repaired in very short time if the lava would stop temporarily or completely. And since this eruption turned out to be a tourist eruption, lava over this road could only increase the value of this visual feast, especially where the lava would hit the sea. So those who can't do this hiking trip up there to the crater, they would get their own show just by the car park, and Iceland would grow a bit larger. Like when we move a bit further west to the village Grindavík, new land, it's a good question. The magma that is coming up there is extremely hot and it can flow for a long way. And the main risk is that we have this ancient fishing huts by the coast. They are at some risk, so they were studied by archaeologists in 2021 after the first eruption started, but that place is however a bit further east than we expected lava to come, so we hope it won't ruin that place. And I have to say that it is both terrifying and fascinating, this irreversible change in landscape that's taking place now. And some of the most important footage I got in this trip was the so-called before footage. The videos are shot from the region only days before the eruption came up, and of course one of the first drone shots after the eruption started, and I have been documenting this now since well before the first eruption, and I do have a feeling that some of my oldest videos about this, despite the bad sound recording and other technical problems, they might grow in value for my channel by time, because they contain some of my thoughts back then. And that will be useful material when I turn my footage into a documentary at some time point, maybe after eruption number 5 or 11. I'm just gonna see how it goes. But this eruption goes on and I'm back north. My next trip south will be soon. I needed my own desk for a while so I can start to process the footage I brought back, make some stories from it, and finish some videos that I was already working on when the seismometers made me throw everything away. And I have to admit that I was exhausted after this trip south. All the tension before the eruption and the excitement to get some of the first videos from there. And then this terrible pain in my legs after walking 20 kilometers for shots like this. And I will never forget this moment when I was trying to get out of the car when I got back to Reykjavik. I could hardly walk, but I made it to the volcano with my heavy backpack and I'm in way better shape now. And the next time I have to do something different, so I will have two new cameras with me, the 360 camera and the super zoom camera. But the new problem I'm having now is that it's just hard to get all my stuff up there. Like in the trip now, I had to leave my Nikon behind, my zoom lens and my tripod, since I took two drones with me. And the new drone has this huge remote control, so my camera backpack was stuffed. So I have been getting those e-bike suggestions on my channel again and again. It wasn't on my plan, but it's very clear that if I'm going to take my full set of cameras up there, it's impossible for me to carry it up alone. So after some research, I found a suitable e-bike model that I can fold together to have in a car. And the channel support that I have been getting is now aimed to this, with many thanks to you who have been taking part in this project with me, since it was not an easy task to make this channel into a reality. And it's still young, and plenty of tasks to come. And I'm ending this today with the 7-day earthquake map, and I have to say that experts have not been talking so much about the next moves from Mother Nature. They have had their hands full with this volcanic eruption. But like we expected, the seismic activity dropped a whole lot as soon as the eruption started. But this unrest that we see now in the next system to the east is looking more and more suspicious. And I have not seen this lineup before. And then we have facts like when one of the systems on a peninsula wakes up, they all do. And this system, it is the system closest to the metropolitan area. And we have to bear in mind that the eruption that we are looking at now is just a very small tourist eruption. And when we look back, it is hard to imagine a 20 kilometer long fissure just by the city erupting. But that is, however, what happened during the last volcanic chapter on the peninsula 800 years ago. So recently I noticed this volcanologist expressing some concern about the location of some new districts in the metropolitan area, or to sum this up, we ain't seen nothing yet. However, I don't want to be over-dramatizing this. We don't expect the system that is so close to the city to erupt within the metropolitan area, but when we are 5 kilometers south from the city, it's another story there. Like this crater is the easternmost crater, and the lava from it flowed all the way to the sea, and it is quite enough to look at those faults between the city and the mountain ridge on the plate boundaries to see that if the first settlers were geologists trying to find a place for a capital, it wouldn't have been there. So this will be one of my main tasks in the coming weeks, or to show you the risks, the landscape and the volcanoes around the city, because this story about this long chapter of unrest on the Reykjanes Peninsula has just started. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.